So this is part two of my Thailand video. My first video chronicled my Dubai and Bangkok experience. And so this video will pretty much be a pickup of where I left off on that video. When I left Bangkok, we went to a place called Krabi, which is spelled K-R-A-B-I. It is a small part of Thailand at the bottom of Thailand, which is pretty much at the bottom of Asia. It's near Malaysia, Cambodia, Singapore, places like that. And it's not a very visited place. It's not the most popular attraction to visit, like Phuket and Bangkok. A lot of people don't really go to Krabi, and I found it pretty much just by doing research. I wanted to go to beautiful beaches and just be in nature, and Krabi was the choice that I made. We were going to go to Chiang Mai first, but the more research I did, the more I kind of wanted to steer away from Chiang Mai, was because they don't have a lot of beaches. I wanted the beach. Wherever I visit, I need to be laying on somebody's beach, okay? You see this tan I got? This is from Krabi right here, okay? The last day we spent in Krabi, we were in the sun all day, and this is the outcome. So the flight from Bangkok to Krabi was approximately one hour and 20 minutes. The hotel that we stayed in Krabi was called the O Nang View La Villa. It's about a 10-minute walk from the beach, from the O Nang beach, and the name of the place we were in, or the town rather, was called O Nang. So that's why you're gonna keep hearing me say O Nang. But another attraction that kind of steered me toward Krabi and O Nang specifically was because they have free roaming monkeys. And I love monkeys. I've always loved monkeys. They're like the cutest thing. And everyone is just like, oh, they're gonna rip your face off. Monkeys are so mean. Ah. Check my monkey experience out though.
So cute. Oh my god. Woo! Look at her boobs. Of course I'm right now. I'll take a photo of you if you're a monkey actually.
He's coming.
He's coming, look.
Are you recording?
Yeah, I'm recording.
Oh, he wants the whole thing. Hi! Hi!
They love Monique.
So that happened pretty much on our first day being in Krabi. When we got to the hotel, it was early. It was probably around, I want to say 10, 11 a.m., but our room was ready, so they allowed us to check in. Check-in time was not until, I think, 2 p.m., but they let us check in early, thankfully. So we had some time to kind of shower and get settled in, then we went to get something to eat. And then we headed to the beach, and that is where I saw the monkeys. We had tours set up pretty much for every day in Krabi, beside the day that when we got there. So when we got there, we just had enough time to kind of just get a feel of Krabi. The beautiful thing about where we stayed is that it was around everything. Bars, shopping places, not shopping centers. There were no malls or anything. Just, you know, quaint little shops to get souvenirs and things like that. So we were around a lot of bars, a lot of restaurants. You could take your pick as far as what food you wanted. They had 7-Elevens and little food marts everywhere so that you can get toiletries or little snacks if you wanted, whatever you wanted. So that was the amazing thing about being so close to the busy area and the beachy area. And we were surrounded by mountains. That was amazing. I got some beautiful footage of the mountains and us being surrounded by them. Amazing. But let me tell you this though. The hotel we stayed in was horrible. The O Nang View La Villa was horrible. It wasn't so much the staff. The staff was actually very, very hospitable. They were very nice Muslim ladies, but the hotel itself was disgusting. There was an ant infestation. The room wasn't dirty, but the bathroom was despicable. The shower was, that's a total different story within itself. But if you guys ever visit Krabi or O Nang, please do not stay in the O Nang View La Villa. That's all I'm saying. But back to the good stuff. We went to the beach, spent lots of time on the beach, did some yoga, a little bit of meditation on the beach, and then the next day we started our fun stuff with the tours. Which are four islands, and they are just all beautiful. And we went there by speedboat, and I have lots of pictures and videos that I'm gonna be showing you. Underneath the palm trees, you can leave your worries. Listen to the waves. They say you wanna get so high. Breathe me in like air tonight. Listen to the waves.
So high, breathe me in like air tonight. Let yourself unwind, get lost in the garden of my mind. I could be a private island underneath the palm trees.
It was just such a good time. Like, a lot of people don't go, a lot of people don't travel to Thailand outside of Bangkok, but if you ever get the chance, please try Krabi. I mean, you can go to Phuket, you can go to Chiang Mai, you can go to all of the more visited places, but being in Krabi, as soon as we got off the plane, it was this very just chill, nice ambiance. The people were very inviting. They were very enthralled by me and my friend. They just were very welcoming. Like, a big part of our trip too, people kept asking us, you know, how were we welcomed? We were the only black people where we were a lot of the time. Like, toward the end of our trip in Krabi, we saw maybe a couple more black people and some African people, because Thailand is so close to Africa. So we were the only American black girls in a lot of the places we went to, but there was no discrimination. There was no, like, you know, you guys don't belong here, what are you doing here? They were always very inquisitive. They wanted to know, you know, what brought you guys to Thailand? You know, how did you think to come to Thailand? It wasn't in a discriminatory way. It was very inquisitive, and they just wanted to know why Thailand, you know? And we would explain it. But please don't think that the traveling outside of your comfort zone means that you're gonna be discriminated against and there's gonna be racism, because we didn't experience that one time. People were always asking us what we did, you know, since we look young, they're like, oh, you guys in college, do you work? Are you, you know, doing both right now? What are you doing for a living? Just basically encouraging us to constantly keep traveling and being ourselves. we got a lot of encouragement from older couples and things that we met during our trip. But I'm just here to let you know that no matter where you are in your life right now, that does not mean you cannot do the things you want to do. Make time for the things that you love. Make time for the things that you think you might love. You know, trial and error. Try it out. You know, you can never know what you hate unless you figure out what you love. And once you do that, you even be more of a person. You know, your story is never going to stop being written, but continuously build and write that story. For me, I don't know what I want to do with myself. I'm 23 years old. I'm lost. I'm a lot of things. But the one thing that I live by is me making myself happy. My happiness is number one in my life. What I want to do, the things that I want to do, the things that I think I want to do, I try everything. I try so many things. And even if it doesn't work for me, guess what? It just doesn't work. And I try something else. But that does not mean that I have to do one job, be this one person, be the, you know, the poster child for this, whatever society tries to box you into, break out of it, is all I'm saying, you know? Have fun, live your life, and traveling is a part of growing. And that's one thing that I'm learning. Each place that I go to, I fall in love with that place. But it teaches me so much about the world and about people. Here in the U.S., we're very privileged. We have a lot of things that people in other countries don't have, and we take that for granted. So it helps me to appreciate coming back to what I do have. I don't have much, but the things I do have is a lot more than what someone else doesn't have, and a lot of the people I met in Thailand don't have. You know, they don't even, toilet paper is not even something that they give out freely. Paper towels, like when you go to the bathroom, a lot of the facilities that we went to that were like truck stops and stuff, they don't have toilet paper. That's a commodity for them. That is something that is very, it's a scarcity. And we have it, we're just throwing that shit, we're using that shit for everything. Certain, you have to appreciate what you have, and traveling can help you do that. So if you guys have any questions or comments, anything you'd like to know regarding my Thailand trip, please send me a comment, shoot me a message, follow me on Instagram at worldly.roxy. I'll have that in the description box. But please, just if you have any questions, feel free to ask. You know, I'm here to answer anything you guys might want to ask. Thank you so much for watching. It's been my pleasure to have these couple of minutes of your life. Thank you so much for spending them with me. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time. Bye.